Hi friends, David here from Learn Stage Lighting, and in this video, you don't see me, why? Because we are in transition, that's right. I am working out of an electrical closet right now, while I'm moving to a new office, but I wanted to go ahead and make this video here for you to talk about this month's topic, because I'm really pumped this month. We want to talk about easy to set up lighting rigs for mid-size stages, which is what you see in front of you. The idea here, the crux here really, is to talk about, okay, if you're working with a mid-sized stage, what are a couple examples of really simple but yet highly effective rigs that you could put together that would get things done, would get you really awesome possibilities on a mid-sized stage, but not be a ton of work? Because I think one of the biggest things that we run into in lighting is as you grow, as you get to bigger size stages, you get more and more things to set up, and suddenly it becomes a huge pain in the butt, okay? And then you don't want to do it. So what we've got here is, I've modeled everything with truss, but I want to explain this here. So we've got, first we've got two front lights, okay? This is a really popular look and a really great way to front light a stage, and that is to take a strobe type fixture, okay? In this case, this is the ADJ Jolt Panel 300, the JDJ Jolt 300, sorry about that. And the reason why I chose the Jolt 300 is it's a full color mixing light, red, green, blue, and a lot of cool white, but it can still make some really good colors. So like if I grab this one on the side here, it can make a nice red, etc. And I've seen these in person and I've verified that they really can make pretty nice colors. They're not just an effect light. When you have a fixture like this, it's great for these setups where you want it to be quick to throw and go and get it done, okay? So just having one light as the front light on, you know, what is probably a 30 foot or 40 foot wide stage, it's going to get the job done pretty decently, right? Like, is it as ideal as if you had, you know, a nice front lighting system at that perfect 45 degree out and up angle? No. But it's going to do a pretty darn good job, and the only thing you had to roll out, set up, clamp, and cable is one light, right? So it might not be quite as defined of a beam, but I do like the Jolt 300 and their similar models just because it's a 45 degree angle. So it's not super wide, and so that means it lasts a pretty good ways here. It also doesn't like spread everywhere, you know. It's controlled, but wide enough to cover everything. And what I'm gonna do instead of truss for these to roll them out quick is I'm gonna bring these out. So these Chave Flex stands, man, I love these things. I'm gonna buy some soon for my office. Whoops. We can get you these. I think we have them on the Learn Stage Lighting Gear site. If we don't, just bug us and we'll get them for you. And what I like about these is it's just a simple take on the pipe and bass that have been in the theater for so long. But they give you some rubber feet on the bass. They give you some handles, which are so nice. For those of you that have used theatrical pipe and basses, a lot of them in the that are, you know, older ones, they don't have handles. And so they're a pain in the butt to move. And it comes with its pull, and it's an extendable pull. So if you got a short ceiling, you're good. If you got a taller ceiling, I think it goes up to 8 feet. So it's not massive, but it works really well. You know, grab it, maybe leave the light clamped on it, and grab a hand cart, you know, just a hand truck, and you can move this thing in place. Easy. Okay. You can even put a speaker on top of it. So that's cool. So stinking cool. I love these things. And if you only have a couple lights, these are perfect. Throw some weight on the bottom, because they're not, well, it is a cast iron base actually, so it weighs 36 pounds, and the Jolt 300, if we look that up in the other window really quick, the Jolt 300 doesn't weigh a lot, and if it's at the top at full height, just a guesstimate here, you know, it's a 10 pound fixture with a 30 pound base, it probably would be fine even at the full 8 feet without any sandbags. You know, that's not rigging advice for sure. Check it out in your own circumstance, and if you need to put a sandbag on it, that is totally fine and won't slow you down too much. Okay, so that's the front, is ADJ Jolt 300s, we've got them at Learn Stage Lighting Gear. There may be other fixtures that work well for you, on top of a Jove flex stand. Then for the backlight, I've got three fixtures you can see here on each of these uprights, okay? And I used a truss upright, but I'm going to show you a better option here in a second, okay? And so we've got a wash light. Here I modeled it with the Gamma Borealis RC. Nice light, a little bit on the smaller end for this size of stage. But again, you know, when we're putting together a quote for you, if you're looking for gear, just ask us, give us some example of the kind of stuff you do, the kind of stages you play, and we can help you determine like something that's really good for your exact needs, okay? But I put Borealis up there. Then I put Inhalation Darts 360. And then below that, this is an ADJ Jolt Panel Effects. Now this is a pixel mapped fixture, so you get a lot of bang for the buck out of that. And I've got these all on something like this. So the Global Truss has a DT Quick Grid. Again, we can get these, though I don't think they're on the gear site yet at the time of this recording. We'll make sure to get them added. These are awesome because, as you can probably see, you get a wheeled base, which is a separate piece, but you can buy it, okay? So you get the wheeled base, so boom, roll it right into the trailer, to the truck, to the van, whatever. And then you've got up to four sections that you can pin on top of that. Now in this design, I'm thinking four sections tall, okay? Can be black or silver, and we're leaving the first empty, okay? The base on these is not super heavy. I think it's like 15 pounds or something. And so I would sandbag that base down and also put some sandbags in front of the wheels. But all of that stuff could stack up on the base for transport. And then again, we've got fixtures here, here, and here. Okay, so you literally just roll it in, set it up. With that top fixture, that Borealis, if you want to take that and say at times you want to shine it on the backdrop and zoom it really wide, because all four of those zoomed wide would really look nice on a backdrop. And then other times, you're going to use it, you know, for side light, you know, you might light the drummer with them. Of course, you're gonna backlight the band with them, put them up in the air. If you find that you're running into that quick grid, which we totally did, we make that go away? I think we did. But if you find that you yourself are running into the sides of that, the posts of it, when you're panning side to side, then you could always take that light and swing it up. Just loosen the clamp, physically swing the light up, and then that's where it would live every day, and then it could swing back down for transport. But again, I mean, all in all, when I talk to people and I've got people that do setups like this, you know, you can get a really impressive setup that's got three great fixtures on it. The darts I like because it's a color mixing beam fixture, but if you put both of the prisms in and the visualizer doesn't show this well, you get a bright, punchy, wide beam of light with a gobo. The Borealis are there to give you a good wash on that stage, right? And I did four of these across, but you could do six, you could do eight, right? And then we've got the Jolt Panel Effects to give you that unit that if you're doing music or anything really, it can be a strobe, but it can also be or strobe slash blinder, but it can also be a gentle wash fixture. And that one could even go on top and shove the others down, and that one could be pointing down more as your backlight if this was a church or something like that, or go to the bottom and point it up in the air to kind of highlight the ceiling, okay? If it's the kind of scenario where whatever you're lighting isn't a, you know, blind hit people in the face with light kind of thing, you know, if it is a church, if it is you know, a acoustic act, then you can use it differently, and that's totally okay. But my point here, and what I really want to drive home in today's video, is just simply quickly, it doesn't have to be difficult to put together a really cool setup. We'll have links to all of these lights below, of course, on Learn Stage Lighting Gear. And if you'd like help putting together something like this, just shoot us an email, gear@learnstagelighting.com, or head over to Learn Stage Lighting Gear. You can browse everything we've got available, but we're here, we're friendly, and we would love to answer your questions and help put something together for you for your next event. If that sounds great, head over there, and if you liked this, let us know below in the comments. Thanks so much for watching, subscribing, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks.